Today we are going to be looking at trigonometry. By the way, I'm Adedoyin Jeremiah, I'm President Maths or Jerry Springer. So today I am going to be dealing with trigonometry and we'll finish it. We are going to destroy trigonometry. So first, I will first recall the following. I will recall the following. That sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. Cos theta is adjacent over hypotenuse. And the tan theta is opposite over adjacent. You can recall this from Socatoa. This is the basis of trigonometric ratio, trigonometrical ratio, that sine of angle is opposite over hypotenuse, cos adjacent over hypotenuse, tan opposite over adjacent. And when you are given a right angle triangle, a right angle triangle is a triangle that one of the angles is 90 degrees, and you are given an angle, say theta, as you can see. Where this 90 degrees is facing is the hypotenuse. Where the angle is facing is called the opposite. Of course, triangle has three sides. The third side will just be the adjacent. So when you are given a right angle triangle, where the hypotenuse is, where the 90 degrees is facing is the hypotenuse. Where the angle is facing, where the other angle is facing, is the opposite, why the third side is the adjacent. And there is something you need to also know. There is something called cosec theta. Cosec theta is the inverse of sine theta. Cosec theta is the inverse of sine theta. That's whenever you have, when you see cosec, it means 1 over sine. The second, the next one is sec. When you see sec, it is 1 over cos theta. And the last one is cot. This is 1 over tan. This is 1 over tan theta. So from these three things, you can see cosec is 1 over sin theta, sec is 1 over cos, and cot is 1 over tan theta. How do you remember? How will you know that this is actually 1 over sin theta? Because at times, or majority of the time, you might be confused that which one is 1 over sin and which one is 1 over cos. You just need to count the first three letters. This is S, sine. That means this is 1 over sine theta. The first three letters, cos. This is 1 over cos theta. Why this one? Obviously, 1 over tan theta. So that's a very good hint of remembering this inverse trig ratio. Now, let us do something. The first thing I want to talk about, the first proposition is that tan theta is the same thing as sine theta over cos theta. That tan theta, when you have sine theta over cos theta, it is the same thing as tan theta. Now let us prove this. I'm going to start from the right hand side and prove to the left. Whenever you have something like this, and you want to prove it, it's either you start from this one and solve here and prove this, or you start from here and prove this. So now, from sine theta over cos theta, this is the same thing as sine theta divided by cos theta. Sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse divided by, this is adjacent over hypotenuse. Divide it into times, this one will become opposite over hypotenuse multiplied by hypotenuse whenever the biting defense you reciprocate adjacent over hypotenuse over adjacent. So hypotenuse will cancel hypotenuse, so you will be left with opposite over adjacent. And opposite over adjacent is exactly from definition, opposite over adjacent is tan theta. So therefore, or thus, sine theta over cos theta is equal to tan theta. So there is a corollary to this one, that cos theta, because of this, cos theta itself will now be equal to cos theta over sine theta. Cos theta will be equal to cos theta over sine theta. Of course, you can prove this as well. It is we know that cos theta is 1 over tan theta, and this is 1 divided by tan theta. From here, we have seen that tan theta is sine theta, sine theta over cos theta. And this one will become 1 multiplied by cos theta over sine theta, so that I will have cos theta, everything divided by sine theta. So, therefore, cos theta is equal to cos theta over sine theta. So, all these are the basis of trigonometry. So, the first thing you need to know is all these ones, sine theta, cos theta, and tan theta, and all these theories. All this, everything here, you need to know them. And you need to also know that tan theta is sine theta over cos theta, and cos theta is cos theta over sine theta. They will be useful whenever we are dealing with proofs. That's why I wrote it. The only thing I've just done here is I try to prove it, how manage this sine theta over cos theta turn to be tan theta, and how manage cos theta over sine theta become cos theta. That's what I've actually done here. So that's what we have. Now let's go to some other things. Given what we have been doing so far now is I'm trying to build the foundation of trigonometry. Now, given a right angle triangle, what do we have? And let this be the theta. Triangle, say A, B, C. Given a right angle triangle ABC, here will be, let us place the note B, let us place the note A, and here the note C. From here, since sum of angle in a triangle is 180, the sum of angles in a triangle is 180, and here is 90. Here is 90. That means that means the remaining two sides, the sum of the remaining angle will be 90 as well. So here is 90. That means the angle here plus the angle here must also be 90. So this place will now be, let me call this place alpha. If I want to get alpha, I have alpha plus theta must give me 90 degrees, because this place is 90. So if I make alpha the subject of formula, alpha will be equal to 90 minus theta. So that means this place will be 90 minus theta. So now we want to do some things. Let us find sine theta here. What will be sine theta? Sine theta, which is opposite over hypotenuse. Since I'm writing sine theta, I'm dealing with respect to theta. This is here is my hypotenuse. Since I'm dealing with theta, that means this place where the angle is facing, that means here is the opposite, while the third one will be the adjacent. So since I'm dealing with theta, so sine theta is the opposite over hypotenuse, that's C over B. Cos theta will be equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent is A over B. Why tan theta will be equal to what? C over A, right? That's what we are going to have. Now, What of sine 90 minus theta? Now, what will be sine 90 minus theta? 90 minus theta will be, that means my opposite. Everything will change now. That means this implies, or the implication of this is that here will still be my hypotenuse, obviously. Here will still be my hypotenuse. Then, this place will now be the new opposite, because I'm talking about 90 minus theta. So that means this third place will be the adjacent. Now, what is sine 90 minus theta? Sine 90 minus theta, don't forget, sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. So the opposite here is A. A over hypotenuse, B. What will be cos 90 minus theta? Cos 90 minus theta will be what? C over B, right? And what will be tan 90 minus theta? Tan 90 minus theta opposite over adjacent. That's A over C. Now, notice the following. Notice the following. The first thing you notice here is that sine theta is C over B, and cos 90 minus theta is also C over B. Sine theta is C over B, and cos 90 minus theta is also B, C over B. I'm coming. So now, sine theta is C over B, and cos 90 minus theta is also C over B. So that means that from here we notice that sine theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. Why? What's the answer to sine theta? C over B. What's the answer to cos 90 minus theta? Also C over B. So that means sine theta is cos 90 minus theta. You need to take note of this, because this is a great identity that will be useful. Because you might be giving something, sine 30. Sine 30 will be equal to what in cos? That will be cos 90 minus 30. And obviously, if you check sine 30, you will see that you will get 0.5. If you check cos 60, you will get 0.5 as well. So, the same thing too, you can see cos theta, A over B. I can see another A over B again. It means that cos theta, that's another thing you need to take note of. Cos theta is equal to sine 90 minus theta. It will be equal to sine 90 minus theta. This is also important. It's also important. Now, it remains the one for tan. How can we say for tan? It remains for tan. So, for the tan hole, we can see that tan theta, actually, tan theta is C over A, and tan 90 minus theta is A over C. The only thing is that what I notice is that they reciprocate. So look at what I'm going to do. Tan 90 minus theta is actually equal to A over C. But if I want to make it C over A, I just put 1 over. This one is 1 over C over A. 1 over C over A will actually give me A over C. You can verify. 1 over C over A, this one will be 1 divided by C over A, which is 1 multiplied by A over C, which will give me A over C at the end of the day. So this one will now be equal to 1 over C over A. C over A is tan theta. So that means this is 1 over tan theta. And what is 1 over tan theta? 1 over tan theta is exactly what? So it implies that tan 90 minus theta, tan 90 minus theta is equal to 1 over tan theta is what? Cos theta. So don't forget, I have given you before, 1 over tan is cos. So that means tan 90 minus theta is exactly the same as cos theta. So take note of all these things I have given you. It's very important. Now let us look at some examples. Example one. Concerning the few things we have written down, let us do some example without using table. without using table, evaluate. Without using table, evaluate sine 57 divided by cos 33. Without using table, we want to evaluate sine 57 divided by cos 33. So, of course, what is sine 57? In fact, I have not gotten to the aspect of special angle. Assuming 57 is a special angle now, you can easily input or compute the value there. But all these ones are not special angles, and we are told not to use table. We are not to use table or calculator. How do we now evaluate this? So, how do we evaluate the sine 57 divided by cos 33? Of course, you don't know what sine 57 is in your brain, and at the same time, you don't know what cos 33 is in your brain. So, how do you do it? The first thing is that you see that you make sine cos or cos sine, make them the same. The first thing is recall that sine theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. So that means that let theta be 57. Let theta be 57. Since I want to check sine 57, let theta be 57, I will have sine 57. This one will be equal to cos 90 minus 57. So this is sine 57 is equal to cos 90 minus 57 will give me what? Cos 90 minus 57 will give me 33. 90 minus 57 will give me 33. So that means sine 57 is actually equal to cos 33. So as I'm told to evaluate sine 57 divided by cos 33, that means sine 57. Sine 57 is what? Cos 33. Put it there. Sine 57 is same thing as cos 33. That's cos 33 divided by cos 33. Cos 33 divided by cos 33 will give me what? 1. It will cancel themselves. Cos 33 cancel. You will be left with 1. So that means the answer to this question is 1. Sine 57 divided by cos 33. The answer is 1. You can even verify by pressing your calculator, sine 57 divided by cos 33. You will see that the answer will be exactly 1. Example 2. Example 2. Solve for x in the equation given below. Example 2, solve for x in the equation given below. For 0 degree less than or equal to x less than or equal to 360 degrees. The first one here is sine x is equal to tan x. The second thing here is sine x minus 20 is equal to cos 50. And the third one, cos 2x minus 17 is equal to sine 2x plus 43. So we want to solve these three questions. So solution. Now, for the first one, I have sine x equal to tan x. We want to solve for x. Sine x is equal to tan x. We want to solve for x here. Recall that if I want to write sine in terms of sine and cos, what will it be? Recall from the first proposition I gave that tan theta is same thing as what? Sine theta over cos theta. That's where it will be useful. So tan x2 will be equal to sine x over cos x. That's what we are going to have here. So this is over 1 plus multiply sine s times cos s. I will have sine s cos s.
is equal to 1 multiplied by sine s. It will be equal to sine s. Bring the sine s to the, bring it inside. I have sine s cos s minus sine s is equal to 0. Factorize sine s. Factorize sine s, I will be left with cos s minus 1 equal to 0. So that means either sine s equals 0 or cos s minus 1 equal to 0. So that means for this first case, s will be equal to the arcsine of 0. Arcsine of 0. Why this one? This one because s is equal to 1. So s equal arcsine of 0. This one, s will be what? The cos inverse of 1. So what this one means is sine what will give us 0. Like sine s equals 0 means sine what will give us 0. So you say arcsine of 0. So you can easily check this from your calculator. So arcsine of 0, you have 0. That's one of the answers. Because sine 0 will give you 0. You have pi or 180 degrees. Sine 182 will give 0. And then lastly, you have 360. So multiple of 180, multiple of 180 of cosine will always be 0. Sine 180, sine 0, sine 360, sine 720, everything will always give 0. Please take note of that. Now let's come to this one. Let's come to this one. X will be cos 4 will give us 1. Cos 0 will give us 1. If we press half cos of 1, you have 0 degrees. Cos 0, cos act cos of 1 is 0. Cos what again will give us 1? Cos 360. Cos 360 will also give us 1. 360 degrees. So that means that the answer to this question, to if I want to write it here, it means that S is equal to 0 degrees, 180 degrees, and 360 degrees. All these work for, all these values work for the question. So the next one, B. The next one, B. B saying sine x minus 20 equal cos 50. The first thing we need to do is that let's convert cos to sine. Don't forget, I have given you before that cos theta equals sine 90 minus theta, right? These are where you'll be applying it. Whenever you see questions like this, all what I've given you before, you can see that everything I've been doing so far is based on what I have defined and I've given. So this is, now make theta 50. Let theta be 50. That's cos 50 equals sine 90 minus 50. And 90 minus 50 will give me what? 40. So that means that cos 50 is equal to sine 40. Don't forget we are looking for s. Now come back to the question. This is the question. Come back to the question. I have sine x minus 20 to be equal to cos 50. But cos 50 is same thing as sine 40. So replace it with sine 40. Sine, you cancel each other. Or when you take the arc sine of both sides, you cancel each other. Sine, we cancel each other. You are left with x minus 20 equal 40. So that x will be equal to 40 plus 20, s will now be equal to 60 degrees. So the value of x in this case is 60 degrees. Now the third one, cos 2x minus 17 equals sine 2x plus 43. We want to solve this. I have cos here and I have sine here. Make the two the same. We don't forget again sine theta is equal to cos what? 90 minus theta. Now replace this theta with this 2s plus 43. Since I have 2s plus 43 here, let theta be that 2s plus 43. So I can say let theta be equal to 2x plus 43, so that at the end of the day I'm going to have sine theta, but theta is 2s plus 43 now. 2x plus 43 equal cos 90 minus theta again, but theta is 2x plus 43. You put it in a bracket because of negative 2x plus 43. That's what I'm going to have. Now, it means that sine 2x plus 43 is equal to cos 90 minus 2x minus 43. So, let's continue. I'm still there. So, what we follow? What we follow is that I have sine 2x plus 43 to be equal to cos, then I have 90 minus 43. 90 minus 43 will give me 47. 90 minus 43 will give me 47, but I still have minus 2x. Now, recall from the question, now I've gotten that what I've done so far now is sine 2x plus 43 is the same thing as cos 47 minus 2x. Now, come back to the question. The question says what? The question says we should solve cos 2x minus 17 to be equal to sine 2x plus 43. Sine 2x plus 43. So this is cos 2x minus 17 to be equal to sine. This 2x plus 43 is same thing as cos 47 minus 2x. Again, cos will cancel cos. You delete the cos. You will be having 2x minus 17 to be equal to 47 minus 2x. Bring the 2x, I have 2x plus 2x to be equal to 47 plus 17. 2x plus 2x will give me 4x to be equal to 47 plus 17 will give me 64. 64, divide both sides by 4, x will be equal to 16 degrees. So the value of x here in this case is 16 degrees. And that's all for that question. Now let's, so that's concerning all what I've given you. Let's move forward. You can see how the foundation I've laid first has helped us to solve these questions. Now let's go to some other case now. Now given a right angle triangle below. Now we are given a right angle triangle below, as you can see. Let this one be A, B, C. This is A, this is C, and this is B. Obviously, I told you before now that where the hypotenuse is, where the 90 degree is facing. So this is the hypotenuse, this is the opposite, and here is the adjacent. Now, you need to know something here. We need to take note of something here. Now, by Pythagoras' theorem, whenever you are given a right angle triangle, there is something called Pythagoras' theorem. What does Pythagoras' theorem say? It says that the hypotenuse square must be equal to the opposite square plus the adjacent square. That's what the Pythagoras theorem is saying. Now, I have some proposition again to prove. Proposition 2. In other words, they call them identity. They call them identity. Proposition 2 says that number 1 is proposition 2a is saying that sine squared theta plus cos squared theta is 1. The second one, 1 plus tan squared theta is equal to sec squared theta. While the third one is saying that 1 plus cos squared theta equal to sec squared theta. 1 plus cos squared theta is equal to cosec squared theta. We want to prove all this. The first one, recall from the Pythagoras theorem. What does Pythagoras theorem say? Hypotenuse square equal opposite square plus adjacent square. So from this right angle to the angle given, let us write the hypotenuse square. The hypotenuse square is that's a square is equal to opposite square c square plus adjacent square b square. Another way I can write this is I can write it as c square plus b square is equal to a square. It's the same thing. I can write the right hand side first. C square plus b square is equal to a square. Now, from this right angle triangle, what is sine theta? Sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. That's c over a. Sine theta is c over a. What is cos theta? Cos theta is adjacent over hypotenuse. B over a. So that's what I have. So now let's solve. From this Pythagoras theorem that says that opposite square plus adjacent square is equal to hypotenuse square. So I have c square plus b square is equal to a square. C square plus b square equals to a square. Divide through by a square. So this one will become c square over a square plus this one will become b square over a square, then a square over a square, which is 1. A square divided by a square will give us 1. So that at the end of the day, we can see that we have they are both having square. C and A are both having square. Factorize the square so that you have C over A, everything square, plus that other one too. We have B over A, everything square, then it's equal to 1. Now, what is C over A? C over A is sine theta. So that means I have sine theta all square plus B over A. I have cos theta all square, then it's equal to 1. So that at the end of the day, therefore, sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. We proved the first one. So this is very important. It's a great identity. No matter the value of theta, whenever you are told to find sine square theta plus cos square theta, the answer is always 1. Now let us do the second one. We want to prove that 1 plus tan square theta equals s square theta. We want to do the second one, that 1 plus tan square theta equals s square theta. Now recall from 1. Recall from A that I have sine square theta plus cos square theta to be equal to 1. What will happen now is that divide through. Divide through by cos square theta. So I will have sine square theta, everything divided by cos square theta, plus cos square theta, everything divided by cos square theta, is equal to 1 over cos square theta. This one is both, they are both having square. You can factorize the square and so that you have sine theta over cos theta, everything square, plus Cos square theta divided by cos square theta will give me 1. Is equal to this one too. I can factorize square because 1 square is still 1. So I have 1 over cos theta, everything square. If you open the brackets, 1 square, that's 1 times 1 is 1. And the cos 2, I have cos square. So this one will be sine over cos. Recall, what did I call sine over cos? Sine over cos theta is, sine theta over cos theta is always what? Tan theta. Tan theta, all square, plus 1, is equal to 1 over cos. 1 over cos, I gave all this thing at the beginning of the class. This is same thing as sec. Sec theta, all square. So, by the time you open the bracket, you will be true. So that at the end of the day, I have tan square theta plus 1 is equal to sec square theta, which I'm true, like which is what I'm told to do. 1 plus sine tan square theta equals sec square theta. So this is what they want me to do. And that's it. So the third one, C. To prove the third one again, recall from A. Recall from A that sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Divide through by sine square theta this time around. Divide through by sine square theta. This one will become sine square theta divided by sine square theta plus cos square theta divided by sine square theta is equal to 1 over sine square theta. Sine square theta divided by sine square theta will be 1 plus this one will be cos theta all over sine theta all square. Why this one will be 1 over sine theta all square. So this is 1 plus cos over sine will give me cos. I've explained that in the first proposition. The corollary of the first proposition that cos theta is same thing as cos over sine. Cos square theta, 1 over sine is cosec. Then that's square, that's cosec square theta. So I'm done. Again, you can see that 1 plus cos square theta, you always give cosec square theta. So that's what we have. We have this. So that's what we have. So now let's see the next thing we are going to do now. Let's say the next thing we are going to do. Yeah. We want to go into some other examples. Based on what you have been taught again, we want to do some other examples. Based on what we have done, we want to do some other examples. Example 3. Show that cos 2s open bracket tan square 2s plus 3, then everything plus 3 is equal to 0. Can be expressed as 2 cos square 2x plus 3 cos 2s plus 1 is equal to 0. That is the next thing we want to do. We want to do this. Now, what do I have? I'm told that I should start from here. Let me explain the question. Show that all these ones can be expressed as this. They want me to start from this one given cos 2s tan square 2s plus 3 plus 3 equal to 0. They want me to start from there and solve or prove the I come to this. So now, of course, I have told you before, recall from the identity.